If you like to gamble, till you have your man. Win some, lose some, it's all the same to me. Pleasure is to pay, makes no difference what you say. Is the Ace of Spades. Ace of Spades. Ace of Spades. Playing for the hour, dancing with the devil.
Don't break the fourth wall. Oh.
Only 10 more.
I'm deaf, I can't hear what you said. I think you said you're stupid.
Making friends.
The Making Friends Tour.
I'm sorry.
if you knew what was going on inside of here, the circus, 24 hours a day, it's something else, let me tell you. You know, when I play these shows, I pretend I'm a giant golden retriever. I really do. Festival's over, boys were planning for a fall. The cabaret was quiet except for the chilling in the wall. And the curfew had been lifted and the gambling wheel shut down. And anyone with any sense had already left town. He was standing in the doorway, looking like the Jack of Hearts. He moved across the mirror room, set it up for everyone, he said. And everyone commenced doing what they were doing before they turned their heads. Then he walked up to a stranger and he asked him with a grin, "Could you kindly tell me, friend, what time the show begins?" Then he moved into the corner, face down like a jack of hearts. Backstage, the girls were playing, five cards stood right by the stairs. Lily had two queens, she was hoping for a third to match her pair. Outside, the streets were filling up, windows open wide. A gentle breeze was blowing, you could feel it from inside. Lily called out another bet and drew up the Jack of Hearts. Rosemary combed her hair and took a carriage into town. She slipped in through the side door looking like a queen without a crown. She fluttered her false eyelashes and whispered in his ear, "Sorry, darling, that I'm lame," but he didn't seem to hear. He was staring into space, looking over at the Jack of Hearts. I know I've seen that face somewhere before, Big Jim was thinking to himself. Maybe down in Mexico or a picture up on somebody's shelf. But then the crowd began to stamp their feet, and the house lights they did dim, and the darkness of the room when there was only Jim and him, staring at the butterfly who just drew the Jack of Hearts. Lily was a princess, she was fair skinned, a precious child. She did whatever that she had to, certainly flash every time that she smiled. She'd come away from a broken home and had lots of strange affairs with men in every walk of life, which took her everywhere. But she'd never met anyone quite like Jack of Hearts. The hanging judge came in unnoticed and was being wine and dine. The drilling in the wall kept up, but no one ever seemed to pay any mind. It was known all around town that Lily had Jim's ring, and nothing would come between Lily and the king. No, nothing ever would come between them except maybe the Jack of Hearts. Rosemary started drinking hard and seeing her reflection in the night. She was tired of all the attention and playing the role of Big Jim's wife. She'd done a lot of bad things, even once tried suicide, was looking to do just one good deed before she died. She was gazing into the future, riding on the Jack of Hearts. Lily took her dress off and she
buried it away. As your luck run out, she laughed at him and said, well, I guess you must have known that it would end someday. Be careful not to touch the wall, there's a brand new coat of paint. I'm glad to see you're still alive, you're looking like a saint. Down the hallway, footsteps are coming for the jack of hearts. The backstage manager was pacing all around by his chair. There's something funny going on, he said, I can feel it in the air. He went to get the hanging judge, but the hanging judge was drunk. And as the leading actor hurried in with the costumes of a monk, there was no actor anywhere better than the Jack of Hearts. No one knew the circumstance, they said it happened pretty quick. The door to the dressing room burst open, the Colt revolver clicked. And Big Jim was standing there, and you could say he wasn't surprised. Rosemary right beside him, studying his eyes. She was with Big Jim, but he was leaning to the Jack of Hearts. Two doors down, the boys finally made it through the wall. Cleared out the bank, said that they got off of quite a haul. In the darkness by the riverbed, they waited on the ground. One more member who had business way back in town. But they couldn't go no further without the Jack of Hearts. The next day, the hanging sky was cast all over the black. Big Jim lay covered up, killed by a pen knife in the back. And Rosemary on the gallows, well, she didn't even blink. The hanging judge was sober, he hadn't had a drink. The only person on the scene missing was the Jack of Hearts. The cabaret was empty now, the sign said, closed for repair. Lily had already taken all the dye out of her hair. She was thinking about her father, who she very rarely saw. Thinking about Rosemary, thinking about the law. Get off your phone! Get off your phone! Get off your phone! Thinking about the law, but mostly she was thinking about the Jack Fart. Welcome back. I don't personally care if you're on your phone, but maybe the people around you might not want to be lit up like Sith Lords. If I were at a concert and you were on your phone and it was dark and the guy was trying to fucking play like the entire Lily, Rosemary, and the Jack of Hearts, and you were on fucking eBay, I would just be slightly upset. But I want you to know, sir, I love you to pieces.
But how many pieces?
See, this isn't the stuff you do at solo shows. Anyway, this next song is called Yes Sir.
Yes Sir. Beer. Oh, asshole.
Sir, this song goes out to you. What's your name, sir? Tim, this one's for you. You know what? Maybe I'll just...
Which side is it on?
Well, I know I've got to do these two.
We like everybody. Everybody can be just who they are. It's fine. Yeah. I'm just up here by myself, so everything is in play. You know what I mean? That's how you make it good. That's the most anti-rock star thing ever.